Getting out is peaceful. I think getting in is the problem for that. Oh shit.
Do you stop it?
I seriously think someone's broken it or something, because this is not how it's supposed to work. Like, come on, Mahendra, are you guys serious?
Alright guys, I hope you all enjoyed watching the Thar video so far. And next up, we're going to show you the interiors of the vehicle. And Sanu is going to demonstrate as to how we're going to go to the rear row, the back end row of the vehicle. And he's going to show us how to get into it. So let's see. So this is Sanu Kumar, as you all know, and if you all can see the size and the variant of his body, he fits into a pretty heavy segment of sports utility vehicles. So this is how you need to pull the seat up front, because you cannot enter the vehicle from the rear end. So can you show us how to do it again, Sanu?
Yeah, sure. We were just trying to figure it out for like last 30 minutes.
So Sanu was literally trying to break the seat. So reach out, if you're watching this, please don't charge us for it.
So there's a small lever here, if you can see this, which basically has to be pulled on top, which is, that's the only tricky part. Okay, so this apparently...
No, you need to pull it properly.
That's what I've been trying.
Still trying.
Yeah, I seriously think someone's broken it or something, because this is not how it's supposed to work. Like, come on, Mahendra, are you guys serious? Okay, I think we need to call the other guy too.
Okay, we need some reinforcement.
Yeah. Can you stop it?
He just hit his head, guys. So all that you know, the Thar, if you're about 5'10 and above, is gonna be a difficult vehicle to get into if you do not, you know, bend down.
Seat front. Okay.
Hold this, let me try.
Okay.
Let me try.
You don't try?
No, it's not.
Exactly. I don't know what, like, what's wrong with it or something. Or I think basically someone's broken it.
So after a lot of effort, using my core strength and a lot of technique, I managed to open this seat. I don't think this is the case with all the Mahindra vehicles. This is probably a little broken and spoiled, because it is a showroom vehicle, a display vehicle. So come closer, I'm going to get in and show how it's going to fit. I'm about 6 feet 2 inches tall. So if you all can assume, and if you all can, you know, imagine how it's going to be for me to get in, it's all left to you all. So I'm going to push the seat as up front as possible. That was smooth.
So you guys can see that's the only place we have to get in. Like, that's all.
So this is how it feels inside. I have, you know, about 2 people can sit here peacefully. Let me just pull the seat back. I'm actually scared if I cannot get out after this is locked. So what I'm going to do is, I'm going to move to the other side of the seat so that I leave this open, and I'm going to show you all how I am going to be seated. I am about 6 feet 2 inches tall, just like I said. So the spacing here is fairly decent, but just that I do not like, Macha, don't close the seat, I'll belt the crap out of you. This part has a protrusion inside here, if you can see. This is one, and this is the other one, making your placing, you know, it's fine for people who are like below 5.5 or, you know, or little kids. Let me try getting out, because I don't know what's going to happen. Yeah. Smooth enough. Not tall enough, actually.
No?
See, I'm actually breaking a sweat because of how hot it is here.
You want to wear a bikini suit?
I would love to, actually. So that was simply it for how you need to be getting into the vehicle, and, you know, try to space yourself inside, because it's pretty difficult for, and honestly, my opinion, it's actually pretty difficult for me to get in and, you know, try and sit comfortably. If you're someone who's going to be 5 feet five or 5 feet four, or if you want to have little children sitting in the back, mostly, you know, the adults are not going to sit behind as long as it is, you know, it is just around the city. But if you're going to be taking the vehicle on a long run, and if you're going to be going off-roading with it, and that's not the place for someone like me and Sanu to be sitting, because that's not going to happen. And I wish I could show Sanu getting behind at the rear end of the car, and I want to show you how it actually looks. Sanu, you want to give it a shot?
No, I'm good.
I want you to give it a shot. The people want to give you a shot.
Okay, come.
So here it goes, round two of trying to open the CC line. I'm sure they'll lock it.
Is there something seriously wrong with it? Oh, it actually happened, guys.
Work in the first go, man.
Yes, this is the only space which I get to go in. So yes. With my huge body, let's see.
So let's see how someone as fat as someone can get inside.
I'm already feeling uncomfortable.
No, go on.
I got in, guys, but it was tough getting in. So as Sharun said, we do have the protrusion of the mudguards here, and also a small black, I don't know, what is this? What do you think this is? Another protrusion?
It's some opposite part of the mudguard.
I have no clue what is that. I think it's for the coil suspensions. So basically, I would feel rather uncomfortable sitting there, because that being, I cannot, you know, relaxly sit. The seats are pretty good. I like it.
It's actually very comfortable.
It's rather sporty and comfortable at the same time. But yeah, getting in for such a huge personality.
Let's try getting out now.
That's going to be a big... I have no clue.
Okay, getting out is fine. Getting out is peaceful. I think getting in is the problem for that. Oh, shit.
But so getting out was also fun.
You were actually stuck like this.
Yeah.
All right, so let's push the seats back. Yeah, and that is locked.
So next up, we're going to look at the door, because the door comes with the Thar badging here, and you have the standard lock. It does not have the same old pull up and push down lock. If the lock comes, the lock mechanism comes here along with the door opening handles, and you have a nice holder here, and you have some thing here, I don't know what this is. A nice feel, because this does not feel like cheap plastic. It feels good, it feels pretty sturdy, and you have nice space here to, you know, to keep your stuff. You have a good bottle cup holder, you know, along with some extra additional storage space. So yeah, so I'm going to get in and show you. This is the grab rail that we have, and it looks very nice and sturdy. It feels a lot more, you know, premium than my version of the Thar. And we have a glove box here, which is fairly small actually. You can probably fit your documents in, that is it, nothing more than that. And it does not have any cooling options here. And you have a speaker mounted here, and that feels very good because you don't have additional work on your speakers. The Thar actually comes with a touch infotainment system, which feels really, really good to look at. I don't know how it is in function. So we're going to see that in the next video when you drive the Thar, because this particular model has the batteries disconnected, so we cannot turn the ignition on. And we have four AC vents, just 1, 2, 3, and the four on the driver's seat, number four on the driver's seat. And you have the AC controls here, the fan speed, 1, 2, 3, 4. And you have the temperature speed, you know, controls here. And you have the other AC controls, like, you know, direct hit and, you know, to your leg and only leg and all that, and the heater and everything. And you have the AC button option here and all of that. So this comes with two USB options here, which you can connect your phones and you can charge your phones and everything. It comes with the aux cable option here as well. It comes with a 12 volt cigarette lighter and a charger, which you can connect your fast chargers and your third party adapters. This entire part, this gear lever has been entirely changed, and it feels so good to hold this, because with the one that I drive, literally feels like I'm driving a lorry, because the length of the gear lever, and it feels very difficult when I'm trying to shift gears from first to second or third, because it usually has this, you know, noise that it makes. And another major update or major change is the four-wheel drive gear lever. This used to be on the right hand side down, right next to the clutch lever there. So that has been shifted from there, because that, for someone of my size, would be very difficult to sit and stretch my legs when I'm driving long distances, because that usually protrudes out and it does not make you feel too comfortable while driving. The seats here are very comfortable. I like this nice padding, the cushioning that's been done on the sides here. It actually makes You feel very comfortable while sitting. It does not feel like the old Thar, and the old Thar's seats are actually on the harder, the stiffer end.
Yeah,
so it's very stiff to sit, and you know, not a lot of people find it comfortable.
That's how it felt a huge difference when I sat behind, right? Like, yeah. I was telling you, than the old Thar, these seats are like very, very comfortable. It was just the part where I couldn't get in. But
somewhere down the line, I actually missed the side-facing seats, which actually comes as an option in this Thar in the AX variant. So we're just going to take a look at this engine bay area. So Rana's going to help us in opening it. So that's why you open the latch.
These are actually cool.
Yeah, that's more like the Wrangler's design. I wish it had that hydraulic
lift it and throw it.
Yeah, that would have been like a good addition, but it's good, man. You have the coolant area here. So this is actually a lot better because this cap makes a lot of sense. Mine, what happens is when it heats up, it tends to blow off. It just opens off and the coolant, like, you know, overflows when I'm doing long distances. The son was trying to squeeze his head inside. Let's see what he's trying to find.
I was trying to find the turbo.
Did you find anything? The turbo?
Yeah.
What do you want to do with it?
I just love turbos, you know, like the sound the turbo makes, the way.
And Mahindra has always been this company which you know, which has its turbo. If you listen to it in the Scorpio or in the XUV,
exactly.
Once you go beyond the 3000 RPM limit,
just
it has on sound. That is a blow off. No, that's a petrol turbo. That's a blow off in the petrol turbo. Don't. Macha,
I just got a little.
Over up panna kudadu. Okay.
Ella potan vechka adi vaanga.
Alright guys, so the next video is going to be all about the driving experience of the all new Mahindra Thar, and I don't know why, what made me take this shot, but let's see.
I think this is better. So I want to thank Sirish Auto Mahindra for allowing us and giving us permission to shoot their vehicle, their display vehicle, and for giving us time to do whatever we wanted, because we actually tried doing a lot of things. And the vehicle actually held up, so that is actually a good thing, a good sign that the vehicle is very sturdy. And this is going to be a very big question if it is actually a part of the lineage that Mahindra has been carrying for a long time with its off-roading, you know, essence in its vehicles. So this is claimed to be a hardcore lifestyle vehicle more than an actual off-roader. So let's see and let's decide on that, and let's see what experience we are going to get once we get to, you know, driving the vehicle, and once we are going to be sitting behind its wheel. So I will see you all in another video related to the Mahindra Thar 2020 that we have here. We're going to be driving it soon. We're going to be showing you all the experience that we're going to have, and I hope you all enjoy watching that as well. So if you all like this video, do subscribe to my channel. If you're watching my channel for the first time and watching my videos for the first time, do make sure you all share it with your family and friends. And also, I need all your support, because this is something that we actually have a lot of passion in doing. So I hope I, you know, have your prayers and blessings all my way. So thank you so much for watching this video. Stay armored, stay safe. I will see you all soon.